Dear students, in the previous lecture we have studied the Newton's third law of motion, which states that to every action there is always an equal and opposite reaction, and the forces always exist in pair. On the basis of Newton's third law of motion, we have the following implications: that action and reaction always act on different bodies, that's why they never cancel each other. But if the forces are acting, equal and opposite forces are acting on one body, then they cancel each other, and the forces of action and reaction cannot cancel each other. No action force can occur in the absence of reaction force. On the basis of Newton's third law of motion, the following daily life examples we can explain, and it help us to do the daily life situations. For example, when a ball is dropped from some height, it rebounds back. Why this is so? When the ball strikes the floor, it exerts the action force, and when the floor exert equal and opposite force, that is the reaction force on the ball, due to the reaction force the ball rebound back. Next question: why a person is able to move? Why the walking of a person is possible? Dear students, when a person walk, then while walking we press the ground with our feet slightly slanted in the backward direction. The ground exert an equal and opposite force on us. The vertical component of the force of reaction balances our weight, and the horizontal component enables us to move forward. This is why a person is able to move. In the picture, you can observe that when a person is pressing the ground from here in the backward direction, the action force is applied here, the ground in reverse gives the reaction force. Now this reaction force is not in the vertical direction and not in the horizontal direction. This reaction force is at an angle theta with the horizontal. So resolve this into two components. One is the vertical component, that is r sine theta, and the horizontal component, this is r cos theta. Now the weight of any object always acts in the downward direction, and here is the vertical component. So this vertical component balances the weight of the body, and this horizontal component, that is r cos theta, is responsible for the forward motion of the object. Similarly, when we press the ground, then earth also moves, but we are not able to observe the motion of the earth. Why? This is because we know the formula F is equal to ma. When force is constant, then mass is inversely proportional to the acceleration. If the mass is very very large, then a very small acceleration is produced. When we press the ground, we press the earth, earth moves, but the acceleration is so small that we are not able to observe it. Now one more daily life situation is there: how this swimming is possible, how a person can swim. Dear student, when you are swimming in water, what you do, you pushes the water in the backward direction, and this push of water in the backward direction act as the action force, and then this water apply the reaction force in the forward direction, and due to which the swimming is possible. Next, one more example: that how a person from boat can jump on the seashore, how it is possible. It is again the application of Newton's third law of motion. How it is possible? When the person from the boat presses the boat in backward direction, it applies the action force to the boat, And in reverse, the boat applies the reaction force to the person. That's why the person is able to move in the forward direction. And while jumping, boat moves in the backward direction and the person moves in the forward direction. And only the basis of Newton's third law of motion, this process is possible. Now, next example is the launching of rocket. How the launching of rocket is based on the Newton's third law of motion. Dear student, inside the rocket there is a fuel, and when that fuel is burnt, what happens? The exhaust gases comes in the atmosphere, and these exhaust gases act as the action force and applies the reaction force in reverse direction, and that is responsible for the forward motion of the rocket. Similarly, the motion of the vehicle, the tires moves the ground in the backward direction, and the ground gives the reaction force which is responsible for the forward motion of the vehicle. After these daily life example based on Newton's third law of motion, one a very much important application of Newton's third law is the horse and cart system. What is the horse and cart system? Dear student, first of all, see what are the forces acting on this horse cart system. Here, first we consider the motion of the horse as a one system, free body diagram, the motion of the cart as the another system, and the combined motion as a whole system. So first of all, we check which are the forces acting on the horse. First of all, the weight of the horse is acting in downward direction, that is equal to mg, and the horse is moving in forward direction and presses the ground by applying force F in a slant direction, and this ground gives the reaction force in opposite direction. Now, dear students, resolve this reaction force again in two components, the horizontal component and the vertical component. This horizontal component is responsible for the forward motion of the horse, and this vertical component that balances the weight of the horse. Due to this forward motion of the horse, what happened? The string is having a tension force in the opposite direction. While pulling the cart, the tension force is produced in the string. Now, see students, there are two forces. One is H, that is the horizontal force, which is the forward responsible for the forward motion of the horse, and the tension force which is produced by the horse in the string. These two forces are acting in opposite direction. And how the horse can move? Horse can move if this force is more than the tension force. Is it okay? The horse can move only when the force in the forward direction is more than this tension force. And now, if the horse is able to move in the forward direction due to the larger value of H, let A be the acceleration of the force. Now, net force acting on the horse will be this. H minus T is the net force when the horse is moving in forward direction, and that is equal to MA. The second situation, the forces on the cart. The weight of the cart in downward direction. The cart is moving in forward direction, the tension force in the string. If it is moving in this direction, then a force of friction is acting in the backward direction, and the normal reaction force in upward direction. So equate these forces. This normal reaction force, R dash, that balances the weight of the horse, and this tension force in the forward direction and the friction force in the backward direction, dear student, now again find the situation, when will this cart move? This cart will move only when this tension force, this is greater than the force of friction. And again, let A be the acceleration of the cart. What is the mass of the cart? Small m. So the equation becomes T minus F is equal to small m into A. Now you have these two equations, gives number one to the horse system and number two to the cart motion. And now add these two equations. By adding and solving these two equations, you have the acceleration of the system. This is the acceleration of horse and cart system. So on the basis of Newton's third law of motion, dear student, you can explain, you can understand how a horse is able to move a cart.